Now that is some deer sausage that I made up with some sausage seasoning that I got off the Amazonian.
Amazon.
Deer meat, pork shoulder, or pork butt, I can't remember which, but it had a lot of fat on it, and some bacon. I made up some other that I have in the fridge right now that is, well, it's down in that bag, can't really see it, but it's actually sausage that's in casings. I gotta work on my camera angles. It's got hard in it too. It's got everything the same except hard in it and more seasoning, so it should be fine. Anyway, I got tired of waiting on Trayvon. He's supposed to be here earlier, but he's not. So I'm gonna go ahead and make up these tacos right now and just get it done, because I'm hungry, hungry, hungry.
Yeah, boy. The first day, it feels nice, man. It's cool out here, a little overcast. Ooh. Saturday's coming, Mr. Krabs. I'm coming for you.
Look who finally showed up.
So I guess you didn't get lost, did you?
No, man. I told you, my boy. I told you. What's
going on? Come on, man.
Hey, Danny, let me get back with you, bro. You too, later. Has arrived.
What do you think, man?
I like it. Dude, that's a big change from the last time I was here.
Yeah, there's a fridge behind you and everything.
Yeah, where the hell did you get this red fridge from, bro?
Home Depot online.
Yeah. Dude, got the shitter in here, man.
Now you gotta use a bucket, but you know.
You say what?
You gotta use a bucket still. Flush it.
Man, you got water now.
It's just not over there, though. I haven't got it over here yet.
Dude, it looks good in here, dude.
Thanks, man.
Hey, one of you guys, look. I'm going to be like you.
Did you ever eat anything?
No, I never ate nothing. I just got my ass out here.
Okay.
I
can heat this up for you real quick and have some tacos.
Where's the trash can? Trash bag. Yeah,
Shandalama.
Moo moo baby. This thing ain't loaded.
So the plan is, the gun's always loaded.
That's not
the plan is, get down to the Ouachita's and try to find a burr tomorrow, or deer, whatever, it don't matter. We're not picky. A pig.
Whatever decides wants to die.
A goat, the wild man of the Ozarks, whatever, it doesn't matter.
Whatever pesticide.
Wait a minute. I am the wild man of the Ozarks. You can't kill me, man.
Except that can of stuff you showed me the other day, that Bo Cephas's butt powder or something.
I see the wife's penguin chair.
Oh, yeah. The swing? Oh, yeah. The rope swing. Well, yeah, her and the girls. See, that's why I left no rail on that side.
Yeah.
So that they could swing back and forth. I don't even think it was a...
It wasn't floored when I got
floor out. Floor or nothing, dude.
It wasn't floored.
Did you come back after it's floored and I had that in here?
I ain't came back since. So, remember that one night we was thinking it was cold as shit?
Did I have that little heater going over there? And it was right here?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, over in the corner.
Okay.
Yep.
So that little bastard over there...
Pushed it out, huh? Put your ass out of here.
It's hotter than the horny whore in church.
Now, what,
well, I went up to Missouri to get the stove, but yeah, I built, that's all rock out of the backyard back here. And then I did the stove pipe and all that.
So the next question.
And the heat shield and all that stuff.
So the next question is, you got the stove from Missouri?
Yeah. Go up to Branson and hang right. So, once again, two buddies are hanging out at Bobcat Cabin. The last time Trayvon was here, the cabin wasn't nearly as far along as it is now. So it was fun to see the expression on his face as he was looking around at all the new additions. You know, hunting is many things. There's the chase, there's the gutting and the gilling, there's the eating, there's the sharing with friends, but really, one of my favorite parts is the fellowship involved with it. We haven't really worked together, Trayvon and me, for a long time. I still see him at work every now and then, but not like it used to be on the yard crew. So this is a chance for us once or twice a year to just catch up on everything. Morning, everybody.
My bad, brother.
Well, we're up. My alarm went off.
I heard and it. He didn't do shit.
I kept snoozing.
Like a bum.
That's all right, though.
No, it ain't.
You know,
here's the beat.
That buck that I killed last year on public land.
Yeah.
Was it about noon? After everybody had already come in and World War III had happened.
I believe.
In the woods.
You know what? I watched a video on a guy talking about people that, you know what I'm saying, get in the woods and say, well, we gotta let the scent stuff dust down. He said, that's junk. If the deer's there, they're gonna be there.
Yeah.
If they're gonna be gone.
If they're not, they're gonna be gone.
He's like, I don't believe in that getting in the stand the whole hour before or nothing like that. He was like, whatever's in there, it's gonna be in there. If you want.
Dude, I have literally hung a stand on this property at like noon. Just looking for different places to hang stands, hung one, got up there all sweaty, and like an hour later,
deer.
This little doe comes through there. Bouch!
And she was dead.
I got it.
Bites the dust.
Yeah. I was like, oh, sweet. That day Mahala got her doe?
Yeah.
Hell, we slept in. My plan was to get down there like way before daylight and get in the blind, you know. Dude, it was, the sun was peeking out. We got down there about 7:50.
Yeah.
And there was that doe eating winter rye. We didn't even make it to the blind. We shot from behind the blind. using a tree branch. When I say we shot, I mean she shot. Like, I just sat there and talked her through it. It was awesome. Making up the coffee, baby.
When all else fails, B.
Huh?
When all else fails, you just gotta learn how to tie some fucking knots, bro.
Did you get it?
When all else fails, you just gotta learn how to tie knots. Oh shit, my stomach.
That'll be good, Dr. Jones. That is going in there. I think we're just very nearly ready. Go in and get it. You got a hat? You need one? Stand. I had to take a growler, so I told Trayvon to keep walking, and he didn't get 60 yards from where I sat down, and he spooked a bear off, so they are definitely in here, which is good. Hopefully that bear will be back. There's already acorns all over the ground. Kinds of stuff. There's definitely a bear working in here, and we found a couple scrapes on the way in from a buck that's been running this area right on the trail, so maybe, Lord willing, we'll get a shot at something. It'll be awesome. Feels good to be back in the woods hunting again. It's been a long year with COVID and everything else. And it sure is nice to be back, you know what I'm saying? So it's just awesome. Just awesome.
muscadine vines like everywhere up here. We actually saw some muscadines on the way in, but it looked like something had eaten most of them. Probably a bear or a deer. I'm hoping that there is more than one bear on this mountain. And we get a bear to come in here, or that bear that we spooked this morning, maybe it comes back. God damn it. I've got ants on me. This is a good stand except for all the damn carpenter ants on it. So it's not quite 10 in the morning. The thermals are still rising uphill. The wind's kind of, there's not very much wind right now, that's for sure. But I would imagine that the thermals were going uphill. Look at that ant. Big ants. Anyway, I haven't seen anything yet. Except that deer. Not a deer, that bear that Trayvon spooked out. I never saw him. I heard something take off through the bush. But I never actually saw it. Something comes in from my left to right. That way maybe I can shoot without even standing up, but I'll be happy just to see something today. My expectations aren't real high for today being out here, but I'm with a good buddy. I'm in the woods. I'm in a tree with a bow. Spot, so I don't know what else you could ask for. The Lord's pretty awesome. You know, I got a confession to make. This last year I've gotten kind of cocky, I guess, because I've had so much success in the field, hunting and whatnot. You know, I got a couple raccoons last year. Deer. I got a nice buck on public land, on a public land hunt. Between the two of us, we killed 5 deer last year, and it's just been awesome. But sometimes I forget that hunting luck like that is just a gift from God. I had nothing to do with it. So I gotta remember to put him first. And then everything else just works out. And that's pretty cool.
Maybe I can rustle something up. come by you or something.
Did I get pretty high off two sticks?
Yeah.
How high do you think this is?
10 or 12 feet at your feet. So your head's 18.
It's like an answer to you.
Yeah, mine too. Carpenter is. Biggins.
Biggins. I've been killing all morning.
Which way did that bear run? Up that way?
I seen back up in the service on my. I get down, which line took me?
Huh?
I get down, which line took me?
Oh, whatever, man. You never know, I might scare something back up towards you or something. I think this will be a good spot to hunt in, like all year long, all season.
I really do. There's a lot of sign in here.
Yeah.
It's like many hollows everywhere.
And once it clears out all the leaves, you'll be able to see for a long time.
If you look from up here, there's many highways everywhere.
Huh. So, we're getting down out of the tree. It's a little bit past 11 in the morning, and we haven't seen much. Trey spooked that bear not 60 yards from the tree stand we came in this morning. But after that, it's been nothing but acorns raining down all morning. The acorns are really dropping right now. It is late September and it's just raining acorns. So anyway, he's coming out of the tree. What we're gonna do is we're gonna follow this trail on up a little bit. So far we found two scrapes that look pretty fresh on the trail, and if nothing else, we found a pretty good spot, I think, that we could hunt basically all year, all season out here. I haven't seen too many other hunters in this area, and it seems like there's a lot of sign, a lot of food, all kind of stuff. So there's another ravine up here and then another saddle. We're gonna go, or a draw, whatever you call it, and we're gonna go up there and see what is what. Come on. There's a pretty good scrape right here. So they be in here. There's another one down here. This bear has been eating the termites and stuff out of here, and you can see where he dug his claws in. There, there, there. You can see how he ripped it out. a rotten log doesn't usually just explode like that. So yeah, there's a bear in here working, and Trayvon spooked him out this morning. I think he might have spooked Trayvon out a little bit. Pretty cool, man. I'm looking for hair or anything like that. I don't see any. And this scrape wasn't here the other day. He said he's coming from this direction, so he scraped like this.
Yeah.
Hook and branch and scrape. Well, looks like no dice on opening day for me and the predator. But that's okay. We had fun. We saw all kinds of bear sign. Trayvon saw a bear. That's cool. Being out here in God's country and creation is way better than being at work, way better than sitting on the couch. Better for you, too, I think. Huh?
If you get done with a hike, you want to be in a couch.
Yeah. Kill one of them?
Joey got patience, bro.
I
gotta give it to him.
I
gotta give it to him.
Never pass up on the first day what you'd be happy to have the last day of the season. That's my motto.
Yo, my G got patience. He said he's going back out this afternoon.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, dude, hey, you can't beat it, bro.
I think I'm going to go out this afternoon. I'm going to be at the cabin anyway.
Stuff set up out there?
Oh yeah.
Might as well
sit
and wait.
Ready to go. Not a bad day, Tigger. Well, folks, when you can't kill anything on opening day, it's not bad to have a consolation lunch.
Yeah, let's go. I love this place.
Fried pie.
What?
Don't
you
can't
say that again.
No,
don't
you
repeat
cannot.
It.
You cannot repeat everything I say, Brad.
Well, folks, we didn't get anything today. We did find a good spot, though. Found a good spot. Spooked out a bear, a little bear that's been working in that area. Other than that, we just had a good morning. It did get hot, though.
It did get hot.
Now, we're going to have lunch at Reed's in Boonville. I think Trayvon's going to go to his nephew's birthday party later and eat some cake.
Man, yes,
probably
sir.
Probably go take a nap.
Two and nine.
And I think I'm going to try to... I'm going to go out this evening on the property and see if I can't put some meat in the freezer. Maybe I'll get lucky and Mr. Krabs will walk by later on this evening. That would be awesome. I can remove him with extreme prejudice.
Word.
Well, folks, there you go. Another day with a good buddy in God's woods on the mountain, and that's always a good thing. Unfortunately, we did not get any meat on the ground today. I came back after we ate lunch, Trayvon and I, and he went out to his nephew's birthday party back in town. I took a little nap because I'm getting old and I like naps, and then I went down to the tree stand down by the feeder, and I could have shot a couple little squirrels, but I was looking for some bigger game. Anyway, We had a good time. It's not always about killing when you're hunting, but don't kid yourself. Filling the freezer is really the ultimate end goal, you know. That being said, being out there with a good buddy, in God's country, and hunting, and just being out there is just awesome. It's good fellowship and good fun, and you're always out there learning new stuff about sign and how to hunt different types of wild game. And it was very cool this morning going in there, knowing, you know, that there was bear sign in there. And then when we got there, you know, Trey jumped that bear. It wasn't a very big one. He just basically saw the rear end of it running off. Said it was about this big running off. I don't know if that tells you how big a bear is by the size of its ass. Anyway, you know, it happened just like that. So I'm sure, I hope, God willing, Lord Jesus please, that Trayvon and I will do some more hunting this season, and it'll be fun. It'll be awesome, and we'll have a good time. It's just the beginning of the season. As I look back on it throughout the years, whenever I've done any kind of early season hunting, I very seldom have success in the way of bringing home meat. But it is a good time to get out there, to get kind of ready for the season, to get your toes wet, to start looking for sign and stuff like that. It's pretty fun, man. It's pretty fun. So, until next time, God bless y'all. Stay tuned. It's going to be a long season. It's going to be awesome. Bye.